Step to Christ, the test of discipleship. There is no evidence of genuine repentance unless it works reformation. If he restore the pledge, give again that he had robbed, confess his sins, and love God and his fellow men, the sinner may be sure that he has passed from death unto life. When, as Aaron, sinful beings, we come to Christ and become partakers of his pardoning grace, love springs up in the heart. Every burden is light, for the yoke that Christ imposes is easy. Duty becomes a delight, and sacrifice a pleasure. The path that before seemed shrouded in darkness becomes bright with beams from the Sun of Righteousness. The loveliness of the character of Christ will be seen in his followers. It was his delight to do the will of God. Love to God, zeal for his glory, was the controlling power in our Savior's life. Love beautified and ennobled all his actions. Love is of God. The unconsecrated heart cannot originate or produce it. It is found only in the heart where Jesus reigns. We love because he first loved us. 1 John 4, verse 19. In the heart renewed by divine grace, love is the principle of action. It modifies the character, governs the impulses, controls the passion, subdues enmity, and ennobles the affections. This love, cherished in the soul, sweetens the life and sheds a refining influence on all around. There are two errors against which the children of God, particularly those who have just come to trust in his grace, especially need to guard. The first, already dwelt upon, is that of looking to their own works, trusting to anything they can do to bring themselves into harmony with God. He who is trying to become holy by his own works is keeping the law, is attempting an impossibility. All that man can do without Christ is polluted with selfishness and sin. It is the grace of Christ alone through faith that can make us holy. Step to Christ, page 59.